And the referee giving instructions prior to this NWA World Heavyweight Championship match as Dory Funk Jr. prepares to defend against a confident and arrogant Buddy Colt. I'm Mark Nolte, joined again by the challenger, Buddy Colt.
You know, Dory Funk Jr. has been a great world champion for several years at this point, and he has always evaded putting the title up against me. He was forced this time to put the title up against Buddy Colt. And right now, as you can see, you're going to find some of the greatest wrestling moves you've ever seen coming from Buddy Colt and from Dory Funk Jr. Dory Funk has been quite a wrestling champion, and he's one of the toughest opponents anybody could ever find.
Of course, Dory Funk Jr. would go on to hold that World Heavyweight Championship for 4.5 years. Buddy Colt leapfrog, the athleticism. Look at the dropkick by Dory Funk Jr. and the arm drag. A little bit of a surprise there is Dory didn't have a reputation for leaving his feet often, but that was a nice dropkick.
Now, as you know, Dory Funk Jr. is a second generation. His father was a wrestler, and is also his brother as a professional wrestler. And his father was a great wrestler, and Dory Funk has been wrestling basically pretty much all of his life, amateur wrestling and training with his father and his brother. And he has become quite a champion. And he has always tried not to put his title up against me because he knows everybody wants to be world champion. This is the only title that I have never held. And right here, at the end of the, we'll see. I don't want to tell you what's going to happen, but Dory Funk should be losing his title tonight.
Well, Buddy Colt, your strength and power on display as you hang on to that side headlock. Big body check by Buddy Colt. Now Dory Funk Jr. with the counter catches you coming off the rope with the abdominal stretch.
Well, an abdominal stretch is very painful across your chest and across your abdomen. And this is a submission hold. Many wrestlers have submitted with the same identical hold at the hands of Dory Funk. And he's putting the pressure on. By moving up and down, he's just stretching it back and forth. You'll never see Buddy Colt submit. Sometimes there might have been a quick pinfall with a fast count of where I get disqualified. But right here, you can tell that Dory Funk wore himself out trying to make me submit.
Buddy, hard to tell from that camera angle. Appears to look like a potential thumb to the throat.
No, I have my right thumb taped up because I've always had an injury to that thumb. It's very tender and very soft, and so it's just to protect my thumb. And what you saw was just an illusion.
Now you've taken the left arm away from Dory Funk Jr. after wrapping it around that ring post several times. One of your favorite tactics is something that you used to break the arm of Johnny Walker with. Something that you use to injure Mark Lewin and Tim Woods, a couple of other names that come to mind.
Well, it's very hard for a man to wrestle with one arm. If you can get one, pick out one arm that he seems to be favoring anyway and start working on it right now with this wrist lock on Dory. Just tear up the wrist, tear up the arm, make him wince in pain, and pretty soon things will be going my way completely.
Earlier in this program, Buddy, we saw that you got the 600-pound Man Mountain Mike to submit after working over his left arm.
Oh, yeah, he was squealing like a pig. I have never heard anybody squeal so loud in my life. I could have pinned him at any time, but I just wanted to hear a 600-pound man squeal and beg for mercy, and that's exactly what he did.
Buddy, are you feeling close to the World Heavyweight Championship at this point in the match?
I feel like it's in my hands. It's within my grasp. It's just a matter of time. And now, you know, Dory Funk there, that wasn't a forearm or an elbow. That was his fist. And fists are highly illegal in wrestling. You'll never see me use a roll-up fist. Always a forearm. And now, once again, he used a fist across my jaw right there.
But look at the determination on your part as you're just getting hammered with those big forearms and fists, and you still continue to hold on to that extended wrist lock.
Well, it takes a whole lot to hurt a real champion like myself. I have a lot of guts. You can beat on me all night long, and sometimes the more you beat on me, the better I get. It's kind of like an aphrodisiac. It just keeps me going.
Back elbow by Dory Funk out of desperation. I think Dory at this point in the match is trying to buy some time. His left arm has been severely injured with your onslaught, and now Dory's going to drop the elbow. You notice he dropped that right elbow, though, and again, his left arm in so much pain, he's having a hard time following up the advantage.
Well, Dory knows that if he can just hang on for the one-hour time limit, that way he can retain the world's title. Now he's going for his favorite hold, the spinning toe hold. And this is how he won the world title from Gene Kaninsky in Tampa, Florida several years back. But it was not good enough to defeat myself.
Beautiful counter on your part, Buddy, as you take away that spinning toe hold with that lip lock. Double underhook by Dory Funk. Beautiful suplex.
This is another finishing hold that's been a trademark of Dory Funk. And he's tried everything he can possibly think of to get a pinfall on himself.
Greco-Roman backdrop. Buddy, you came into this match exquisitely prepared as you've countered Dory's entire arsenal.
Well, right now we're both exhausted. When you get 35, 40 minutes into a match at the pace that we've been going, you are physically drained. Your body is drained. You're breathing hard. It's hard to hold on things, so it makes it harder to get any type of submission because sometimes you just don't have the strength anymore.
Crotch hold looking at body slam cover, and you get so close. Dory gets his foot over that rope. You come up. You think you've won it. Leo Garibaldi trying to wave it off and let you know he did get his foot over that bottom rope.
You know, that was kind of a cheap shot on the part of Dory Funk for sticking his foot over the rope there, but he knew that I didn't see that. If it had been another foot further out in the ring, I would have been the world's heavyweight champion, and that's a title that I would have been able to hold for years because there was nobody in the world that was able would have been able to take that title from me. And now here's Dory. He's down and out. Look, he's exhausted. He can't move, and you see right now I've recovered. And now Dory, like a yellow rat, comes up and sneaks up behind me when I'm not looking. Now, what kind of a champion do you call that one? That's a real sneak attack.
A rolling reverse cradle is going to retain the title for Dory, and you're going to crown him for it.
Well, he needs to be crowned again because of what he did by sneaking up behind my back.